it's Angela from the blog AngelaMarieMade.com. Today I'm going to show you how Brandon and I built our DIY outdoor coffee table. So I thought I had a complete DIY outdoor furniture set, but then I had requests for a matching table. So we built one and it coordinates perfectly with our DIY outdoor couch and chair. The special feature about this coffee table is that it's smaller than your average size coffee table because we built it to go with the matching couch, which is a loveseat size. Also, just like the matching couch and chair, this table is really easy and really cheap to build. It costs less than $20 in lumber for me to build it. Step one is to make the lumber cuts for your coffee table. You can get the full cut list in my tutorial, which is linked below. Going to use a miter saw to cut 6 pieces from the 2x3s for your table legs. And then you're also going to make 2 short board cuts and 2 longer board cuts from the 2x3s that have a 45-degree mitered angle on both sides for your tabletop frame. Step 2 is to assemble the tabletop frame. Begin by using a Craig jig and add 1 pocket hole on each side of the 2 shorter boards that have 45-degree angled ends. Because these boards were cut with a 45-degree angle, they're only wide enough to fit 1 pocket hole that doesn't show on the side of the board. So when you drill the hole for each one, make sure to line up the board carefully with drill hole B on the Craig jig as shown here in the video. Next, add waterproof wood glue between one of the longer angled board ends and the short board that has the pocket hole. Then clamp them down together to your work surface. Use a brad nailer and 2-inch brad nails and nail through the 2 boards together. Make sure to stay away from where the pocket hole screw will be going through. Finally, add a 2.5-inch outdoor Craig screw into the pocket hole to finish joining the 2 boards together. Repeat these steps on the other 3 sides to complete your outdoor coffee tabletop frame. Step 3 is to add the slat boards to the tabletop frame. Measure the exact distance between the side frames and cut 3 1x4s to this size. The measurements should be 37 inches, but since we're working with framing lumber, they may be slightly different. Add 2 pocket holes to each end of the 1x3 boards. Make sure to adjust your Craig jig settings for 3/4-inch thick wood. The slat boards should be attached with 1/2-inch spacing between each of them on the tabletop, so mark with a tape measure on the side boards where to attach them. Then attach with 1 1/4-inch outdoor Craig screws at those marks. Step 4 is to build your coffee table legs. Add pocket holes on both sides of 2 of the table leg boards. Make sure to add them on the side edges as shown here so that the holes will be hidden once they're attached. Next, mark 3.5 inches up from the bottom of one of the table leg boards that doesn't have the pocket holes. Attach the board with pocket holes at this mark, perpendicular and flush with the edge using 2.5-inch screws. Repeat on the other side with another table leg board to form one of your table legs. Repeat these steps again to create a second table leg. For the next step, attach one of the tabletop legs to the tabletop with waterproof wood glue and 2.5-inch deck screws. Make sure the screws are countersunk beneath the wood surface, as you will fill them with wood filler later. I used self-tapping deck screws that don't require pre-drilling. Also, make sure to avoid drilling through the area where your Craig screw is underneath from when we attached the frames together, and also avoid where you put the 2-inch brad nails through as well. Repeat this on the other side for the other table leg. And that's it for the build. The last step is to fill the screw and nail holes in with stainable wood filler and finish any needed sanding. Also, we did sand the tabletop corners some to make them a little more rounded with less of a point. Finally, stain your DIY outdoor coffee table and use an exterior stain. Also, if you didn't stain the 1x3 slat boards yet, a foam brush works really well if we're getting in between the slats for staining. I'm so happy we added this cute matching outdoor coffee table to our DIY outdoor furniture set. I didn't realize how much we needed it until now. Let me know below if you have any questions or comments. Thanks again for stopping by, and please subscribe to my channel.